It doesn't matter how much power our engine makes if we can't keep the thing cool. And that's been a big consideration right from the time we decided to start this project. Given that our original V8, initially we had a lot of trouble keeping that cool, we're now putting a smaller capacity engine in it, albeit one that's going to be making significantly more power. When we make power, that creates heat. We've got to dissipate that heat. So this requires a pretty significant rethink of the cooling system in the car. I'm talking here not just about the radiator, but we've also now got to add an intercooler that's going in front of the radiator, so that of course is going to affect the airflow through the radiator. We've then got our oil cooler for our engine oil as well as our transmission cooler, and last season, even with the V8, we were starting to see the oil temperatures in the transmission creep up. So we want to keep those under control to make sure that's going to be reliable. It's also not just about getting airflow into those coolers, it's also about getting airflow out. So in this episode, we're going to go through the design strategy and the construction of our cooling system.
So today we are working on the ducting for the cooling system, doing some mock-ups. I'll show you what we got going on here.
So the first part we've started with is the inlet for the intercooler and radiator, which are stacked together. So the general concept here is that you want to do an expansion from the inlet to the outlet of where it meets the cooler. The idea here is when the flow is coming in, because you do an expansion, it slows down, and when it slows down, the pressure goes up. Just a basic sort of fluid dynamic principle. And the advantage in reducing the velocity is that it means the air molecules that are in contact with the coolers spend longer in contact, so they do a better job of transferring heat. The other advantage when you increase the pressure is that it effectively increases the density and means more molecules are in contact with the heat exchangers, which again helps your heat transfer. One of the other things that's important when designing a duct like this is to keep the rate of expansion as gradual as possible. In theory, you don't want any angles greater than a roughly 7 degrees of expansion ratio. That's like a theoretical number. In reality, it's really hard to achieve most of the time. Like you can see, we've got a pretty aggressive expansion on the top. That's really just limited by packaging. So at the moment, the inlet for the bumper is somewhere around here. This extends slightly past the inlet. So there's just not enough room to do an expansion as gradually as we'd like to. There is one thing that happens: the closer you get to the cooler, the more aggressively you tend to be able to expand, and that's just due to the blockage effect. So obviously in here the flow is pretty free, but when it comes through the coolers it essentially has a blockage, and that allows you to get away with a slightly more aggressive profile as you get closer to the coolers. So that's what we're trying to take advantage of there. The other thing that's important with your duct is that the front face and these inlets here, which is a little bit hard to see, but essentially that's the line of the tangent of the front of the duct, is in line with the flow as it approaches the car. That helps again with getting everything lined up and keeping the flow attached, because the last thing that you want is the air coming in and detaching and starting to tumble, because it ends up reducing the effectiveness of your heat exchanger. This is at the moment, this is a bit of a sort of a first concept. I'm not sure if this is exactly what we'll end up with. We may try to reduce this angle a little bit more. We'll just have to see how everything fits. One of the other things that's really important when it comes to ducting is getting the ceiling right. So we're trying to direct the air to go in a really specific direction here, and the air will always take its line of least resistance. So what we'll end up doing in the final version, which probably initially is going to be aluminium, is running a flange 90 degrees all the way around with some foam seals, so, and it can be rigidly attached to the front of the intercooler there. And that'll mean that any air that enters this duct will actually be forced to go through the intercooler and the radiator. I should have said before, but what you see here, this is just bracing at the moment to keep the cardboard square. These sections here won't be here. It'll be a relatively sharp edge at the top or bottom there, without these pieces of cardboard, which are just there for the mock-up. We'll also be adding seals in between the intercooler and the radiator. That allows us to stop some direct heat transfer between them both from the radiator to the intercooler, which is obviously running. The radiator is obviously running pretty warm, having engine coolant in it. And The next step we're looking at mocking up is the outlet duct from the back of the radiator. In principle, it's essentially a reverse of what we had at the front. We're going from a large area to a small area. So we're trying to recover the velocity by going from a large duct to a small duct. This is the shape that we're mocking up for the air outlet on the bonnet. So the bonnet line is a little bit above the rocker cover here. So this surface area here is around about 40% of the area of the front area of the radiator. So going from this surface up to this surface means the velocity will increase, and that helps draw air through the entire system. So what we really want is a velocity on the outlet of the duct similar to the free stream velocity of the air coming over top of the bonnet. That's the ideal. Obviously very difficult to validate that without a wind tunnel or some CFD, but that's a sort of some basic working principles of ducting for heat exchangers. So the other thing we have to consider when bringing the duct out of the back of the radiator here is clearing everything on the front of the engine. So we've obviously got the oil pump drive for the dry sump, and the water pump pulley, which is just roughly mocked up here as well. The alternator's down here, but that's not going to be a problem because it's lower down, and these are sort of the worst case scenarios for us to have to avoid on the front of the engine. So like I said before, we want to keep these angles as gradual as possible, but just because of the space restriction here, it's going to have to be a relatively aggressive bend right out at the bottom of the radiator. Because that's air running into a wall rather than running the other direction, we can probably get away with that without causing too many problems, as opposed to if we were trying to do it really aggressively out the top here, you would end up with a lot of separation where air coming out of the radiator wouldn't want to follow that wall. Probably the most challenging bit that we have to fit through is running from the outlet of the radiator core down here in this section because of the inlet pipe and to some extent the intercooler pipe as well. But we did have the guys that fabbed it, Vinny Fab, we had them run everything hard this way as much as they could, which they've done a really good job of. It just means that we'll have to have somewhat of a kink coming through here, which isn't ideal, but you know, that's just what we've got. That's all the room we've got. So ideally we'd be joining up with these corners to the duct, but that's just not going to be possible. And it's not really worth having an aggressive bend right at the top here to rejoin.
So I spent the rest of the afternoon getting the outlet duct for the new radiator setup done.
So in concept, we've got the same thing that we had on the inlet to the radiator. Here we've got this duct starting at the back of the radiator, and it contracts down to the outlet. So this area here represents the hole and the bottom of the duct that we'll have in the bonnet. But we've just got it sitting like this just because it gives a bit more rigidity, helps it hold its shape a little bit better. We'll add a flange to the top of the radiator, and this will have a face that it will seal against. So my plan is to make this, we're just gonna make this out of thin aluminium sheet metal to start with. It makes it quick to prototype, and also if we had to change any geometry, it's pretty quick to cut and weld, and maybe further down the track when we've got a little more time, we'll turn these into composite instead. I'm sure we'll have some mods we want to do to them as well. But before the aluminium ones are ready, we are gonna need to do a little bit of clearancing. So my plan is to make the duct geometry quite simple and then come in afterwards and take out some areas where we need to. So this is gonna meet basically like a rectangular face along the front of the radiator. But there's some areas here like where this V-band clamp is gonna need some extra room. What we'll probably end up doing is just taking that whole corner off and just using some flat section to have a nice smooth transition but give us some clearance to that corner. But the larger problem is the inlet to the turbo. So we kind of anticipated this, which is why we kicked it out over this side. It does kick over quite early, but we're still going to need to take a little bit of material out of here. Tomorrow I will work on finding the shape for that, but essentially what I think we're going to end up with is like a pipe shaped scallop through here, just to give us some clearance. This can run down through here and back original where it was sitting originally along here. But overall, I'm pretty happy with the duct layout that we've got. That kind of gives you an idea of the profile. You can see how it diverges there into the front of the intercooler, which will hopefully give us some nice efficient cooling.
So there you go, there is our design for our ducting and our cooling system. If you've got questions on anything we've discussed there, please ask them in the comments. If you haven't subscribed already, please make sure you do so. This will make sure you don't miss out on any future episodes. And while you're there, give us a thumbs up.